my son, Murray Federman, and Murray's two children, my grandchildren, Marla Federman and Justin Federman. Marla is 10 years old and Justin is 8.
I enjoy swimming with my grandma, and I like her, and I like her cooking.
Say something, Jason. Well, I can tell you that growing up with my mom, she's imparted a lot of special things that we've passed on to our kids: the love for flowers, the love for nature, that sort of thing. If you guys have seen the house, you can see that we've kind of got a feel for the arts. And Marla's a real good artist. She's kind of picked up on that. And Justin likes art a little bit, too. You want to say anything, Justin?
All I can say is that it's been a wonderful life. It's been a wonderful life with my wife, Vera, past 48 years, and I would change it for anything.
So for me to say, yep.
Okay, go ahead and tell me who's in the photo.
Okay, in the front row, in white shirt, kind of a serious look on his face, is my father.
And his name?
And his name? It's Miklos Frank, M-I-K-L-O-S-F-R-A-N-K. And this was taken sometime in 1921, and he just came back from a Russian prison. Mm-hmm. He was a prisoner of war. And right next to him is my cousin, Marika Abraham's grandfather, who arranged this picnic.
Do you know what?
This is the wedding picture of my parents, Jutka and Miklos Frank. Their wedding took place on June 10, 1923. And this photo is not the original. The original photo, when I took it with me, I found it at home. I mean, not at home, but in our former home in Debrecen. I took it with me to Austria, and that was an itinerant photographer who wanted to make a colored photo of it, and here it is. So this was done in 1946 in Linz, Austria, from the original.
And the wedding took place where?
I don't know where it took place. It was in Hungary.
Okay.
This is either my first or second grade class photo. But I rather think it was taken in 1931, in the springtime. And I am the fourth one who's squinting. That's Vera Frank. And next to her is my lifelong good friend, Vera Shiposh.
And she is to the right of you?
She's to the right of me, yes.
And there's somebody standing in the second room?
Well, I can talk about the...
And your cousin is also in this photograph?
Yes, she is. She is in a row... I'm in the first row, second, third row.
Okay, and how did you get this photograph?
Well, my cousin Marika Abrams' son is married in Israel, and she goes to Israel every year. And she somehow, coincidentally or accidentally, met one of our classmates who had this photo. Now, she escaped to Budapest during the Nazi occupation, and she never went to Auschwitz with us, fortunately for her. But she was put in jail in Budapest. Anyway, somehow or another, she saved this photo, and she took it with her to... She gave a copy of it to my cousin, and she gave me a copy of it, and I sent a copy of it to Vera, who lives in Gary, Indiana. So it went around.
Okay.
This is my uncle Isidore on the right, and he died before the war. He had a heart attack. Next to him is his son Andris. Andris was killed in Auschwitz. He was 19 years old. His mother, Atalka, is also my aunt because two first cousins had married, and she too was killed in Auschwitz. Next to her is her big son, Istvan, Pishta, and he was killed in the Ukraine. He was killed either at the end of 1942 or the beginning of 1943. He was in the Hungarian labor service, forced labor service.
And approximately what year was this photo taken?
This photo? Oh, gosh. Let's count back about 15 years from 1944. Let's see, 1929?
Okay. And do you know where it was taken?
In Debrecen.
Okay.
You know, Polish Jews wouldn't like this photo. They would hate it. Because it was taken in 1941, I think.
Good.
I think this photo was taken New Year's Eve of 1941 and 1942. And it was, as you can tell from the confetti, it was a fun party. And my father has a piece of confetti on his shoulder, and that he's on the right-hand corner. And the young man next to him, he actually survived forced labor camp, and I met him after the war. He told me about the fate of one of my cousins. Next, that's me next to him, laughing, and my mother next to me, and half her face is shadowed by me. And I just cherish this photo because it's a more up-to-date photo of my parents, perhaps 2 years before they were killed.
And how did you get this photograph?
Well, my cousin Marika, both her photo albums were saved by some non-Jewish friends in Debrecen. This was actually a little tiny photo, and we had it enlarged many times. It's like somebody finds a piece of diamond and is happy. I'm happier with this. This photo was taken in Sondheim about 2.5 or even 3 months after our liberation. Well, maybe not that late. It was the beginning of July. And I'm the second one from the right. And next to me is Vera. And all these women, or young women, worked in the potato peeler squad with me.
And that was from the Allendorf camp?
Yes, and from the Allendorf camp. And this was in Sondheim, where we were actually liberated, or nearby, by the American Army towards the end of March 1945.
And can you identify any of the people in the photograph?
Well, I know the one to the right is Gabi, and next to it is Vera Frank. Next to it is Vera Sipos. Next to it is Muncy Weiss. Next to that is Berta Schön. Next to Berta is Lulu Kovac. And I cannot remember the woman on the end there.
So you are second from the right?
Yes. This is a piece of identification that the American military government issued to us. This was a particular one issued July 2nd, 1945. And it just merely states my name, where I was born, my age, level of education, and signed by a major who was that was a military government headquarters. And there's my fingerprint, there's my signature.
And what did you need this for?
Well, I think about this time we decided that we're going to go back to Hungary. And I needed this for identification, to be able to actually, I think, to prove that I wasn't in the Wehrmacht or in the SS. Because the reverse side of it, when we turn it around, this paper would be filled out for a member of the SS or the Wehrmacht.
Okay.
This the reverse side of this document has Wehrmacht on it, and had I been in the Wehrmacht, they would have filled it out for me that way. And the bottom part is NSDAP, which means the National Socialist, well, the Nazi Party, at any rate. And so I wasn't in either one of them, but still, I was not allowed to move freely. This is a photo taken in 1946 in front of Susie's house. She was married to a Master Sergeant Charles Heischmann in Linz, Austria, and very frequently I stayed with her for months at a time, especially during winter when it was freezing cold elsewhere and we were not able to heat any rooms. So Susie's on the right. Her maiden name was Sipush Juji, and her married name was Susie Heischmann. And I am on the left-hand side. You're a friend. Here I am on the SS Marine Tiger on my way to the United States. And the date is early January 1948. And looking at the photo, I can see I must have gained at least 10 pounds from eating good, wonderful food on that ship that I hadn't seen for many years. This is my daughter, Judy Federman, and although this is a very old photo, in fact, it's from her time when she was a senior in high school, but I can testify to the fact that she hasn't aged a minute. She still looks the same. This is Judy's youngest child, Dylan, and he's 3 years old, and he's very proud of himself. He's sitting in his father's truck. This is my granddaughter, Rachel Wendell, and here she was 13 and a half years old. She's now 15 and a half.
And whose child is she?
This is Judy's son, Judy's daughter. This is my daughter, Judy's oldest child, Breeze Wendell, and she is now 19 years old. Oh, she will be 19 years old in September. And she goes to a college, and she's always also working during the summer, two shifts. That's why she wasn't able to be here with us. Going from left to right, my daughter-in-law, Lori Federman, my son, Murray Federman, Justin Federman, myself, my husband, Marvin, and my granddaughter, Marla.
And how old are your grandchildren in this photograph?
I think that Marla is probably 8 and Justin 6.